Hey everybody, I'm here today to tell you that you can start a business with no money. If you have a business idea, then there are many ways to start that business without any money. And if your business idea requires a ton of money to start, then you should probably figure out a different way to actually start it. Now, let me break this down for you. So many people have great business ideas and they're willing to put forth the effort, but they think that money is an obstacle or a barrier and that they simply don't have enough money so they can't start the business. And I hate to see those great ideas go to waste for the simple fact and idea of finances, or lack of finances, I should say. So here are some ideas and some ways to get around that little money situation and start your business. So first and foremost, okay, if you have a phone, you can pretty much do anything technology related. That means if you want to start a website, if you want to start a blog, if you want to start a social media account, if you want to start anything at all technology related and grow it to be a business, then you could probably accomplish it from a phone. Now, even something like a website, you might not be able to create a good website from your phone, but what you can do is you can use a computer to create the website of your dreams, and then you can just work on the website from your phone. You can post those articles and those blog posts and so forth from your phone, okay? So even if you can't create it from your phone, you can probably update it and constantly use it through your phone. So technology-wise, you don't need money, you can use your phone. You don't need a crazy computer, you can use your phone. It's as simple as that. Now let's say you have an idea for an app, or you need some help with something. You don't have the skills. Like, you don't have the skills to build a website. You don't have the skills to code your app. But you don't have money to pay anyone to do it. Well, guess what? You can collaborate and offer the person something else of value. So first and foremost, just because you don't have money doesn't mean you can't barter with them. Maybe you have like a nice table that they need for their kitchen. Give them your kitchen table and they'll code your app for you or build your website for you, okay? There are many things that you can give to them that you might have. Or maybe you're a great photographer and maybe they need wedding pictures taken. So you can offer them to actually take their wedding pictures for them in exchange for coding your app or building your website for you. Okay, it's as simple as that. So you can offer to barter or trade with them. And if you don't have anything to trade with them, you can offer them a piece of the pie. Meaning you can give them a certain percentage or a certain cut of what the app earns or of what the website earns. Or let's say, you know, you want to create a video and you need a voiceover for the video. You can offer them a percentage of whatever that video, that specific piece of content earns. There are many creative ways that you can get around not having enough money for a business. And even if you don't have enough money and your business, like you have this crazy huge business idea, this amazingly huge business idea, and it needs cash, it needs money to start up. You simply can't get around the fact that you need some money. Well, then you can raise funds. And I'm not a huge fan of raising funds, but if you need to do it, you need to do it. And the reason I don't like raising funds is because you're putting all of your eggs in this basket that hasn't proven itself to be good yet. When you raise funds, you're pitching an idea most of the time, or just like a pre-type of product. Like, you don't have a working, fully flourishing business most of the time. I'm not talking about all the time when you raise funds. I'm just talking about most of the time. So you're asking for money in hopes and dreams that this is gonna work. Whereas if you started a business without any money and it's proven itself, like your business is earning you cash right now, it's generating a good amount of revenue and you just want to increase or expand or improve that business, and then you raise funds, that's a little bit of a different story because your business has already proven itself to you revenue wise and you're almost certain that when you raise these funds to expand, it's going to just rinse and repeat and just earn you more revenue and earn the people who are giving you the funds more revenue. So the point is this: you don't need money to start a business. If you have a great business idea, if you're willing to put forth the effort, which is the most important thing, if you have a durable personality and you can persevere through the hardships, then you don't really need money to start a business. Like, you don't need the money yourself, okay? First and foremost, there are many ways to get around even putting forth money. There are things that you can trade, things that you can barter, different values that you can give each other with the person that is helping you or that you're collaborating with. Or you can start a business that doesn't require any money. Like, a social media asset basically requires no money and can generate multi-six figures a year. So what it comes down to is this: you don't actually need money to start a business, okay? And even if your business does need cash, then if it's a really, really incredible idea, you can probably raise that money. And as much as I'm not a fan of doing that in the first place, in most cases, I'm not a fan of doing that. You know, it's possible, and it, like I said, it's up to you. You're the one that's raising the money. You're the one that has to do it. So you shouldn't be listening to whether or not I'm a fan of it. Just look at your business idea and think, like, am I almost absolutely certain that it's gonna produce revenue? And ask like 100 people that aren't your friends. Would you buy this product? Would you invest in this? Like, just go to people and ask them, that people that don't know you, people that aren't your friends, ask them for their honest opinion, and they'll probably give you their honest opinion. Or even ask a friend to ask people, because if they're saying it to you, they might still be biased to try and not hurt your feelings. So ask a friend to say, this is my friend's business, would you buy this? Or, I'm doing a project on random business ideas, would you buy this? This is not my business. Like, you know, you really have to try and get an honest opinion, because, you know, you might go and raise hundreds of thousands of dollars and the business might not earn you anything, okay? It's as simple as that. So with that being said, I just wanted to do this little business advice slash motivational rant video to tell you that you know, businesses don't need money, okay? You don't need money to start a business. And the majority of businesses that really succeed, they don't need a lot of cash up front. You know, they just need a little bit to start, and then they keep building and expanding once the idea has proven itself. I really hope you've enjoyed this video. If you liked the video, be sure to give it a thumbs up. Let me know what you think down below as a comment. And of course, be sure to subscribe for more great videos just like this one. And that's all I have for you today. Thanks for watching.